Embattled EPA Chief Scott Pruitt, now facing more than a dozen ethics investigations, goes along with countless scandals since he took office. And now there's also this. Three sources tell CNN that Scott Pruitt directly asked the President of the United States to fire Attorney General Jeff Sessions and replace him with Scott Pruitt. Here now to discuss this, CNN contributor Norm Eisen. He's the former ethics czar for the Obama White House. Norm, Ambassador, great to have you with us. Happy birthday, America. This notion, Caitlin Collins was the first to report this, that Scott Pruitt says, hey, Mr. President, you should fire Jeff Sessions, slide me into that position using the Vacancy Act. You actually question whether, in fact, it would even be legal.
John, thanks for having me back. That's right. Back in March, when we first got a whiff that this ploy might be going on, I wrote and explained that there's a law called the Vacancies Reform Act. It lets you replace somebody who dies or quits with someone else who's already been confirmed by the Senate for 210 days. But it doesn't say anything about firing somebody, about ousting somebody, about one cabinet secretary. Think about it, John. It's like Shakespeare. One cabinet secretary going over there to the White House, putting the knife in the back of another one, saying, hey, put me in that job, Mr. President. If the president had done that, he would have been acting illegally. And that still would be the case.
So what you're suggesting is that maybe Scott Pruitt doesn't have a solid understanding of the various ethics laws that surround good government?
Well, I think after the 13th investigation, we know of 14. Some say there's as many as 18. I think after the 13th investigation, John, we could conclude that his knowledge of law and ethics is a little deficient. The luxury lobbyist condo, firing people who had the temerity to question him, the excessive spending that he's done many times his predecessors. But this nails it, John.
Let me just read some of the, you know, again, there are 13, I think, active ethics investigations. That doesn't include all the accusations and scandals. Let me just read through a few of the things going on here. He asked the president for Sessions' job, placed an old ally in charge of FOIA requests, kept a secret calendar to high meetings. That's a CNN report, which is fascinating. Sought a Chick-fil-A franchise for his wife, accepted courtside tickets to a University of Kentucky basketball game, $43,000 for a soundproof phone booth, 24-hour security detail, travel expenses, housing controversy, pay raises for close aides. They didn't even put up on the screen my favorite, reportedly asking a security detail to go out and look for a special kind of lotion that he likes. I don't know which one to ask you about specifically, but let's ask about these apparent repeated requests from people who work for him, for the government, to go help find jobs for his wife. What's wrong with that?
One of the most fundamental principles of government service, John, is that you take public office in order to serve the public. And when you use your public office, as Pruitt has done again and again and again, allegedly, but there is strong evidence of some of these allegations, when you use it to line your own pocket, and in particular to benefit yourself, when you're ordering other people, there's reports in recent days that he went so far as to tell some of these junior aides to put his hotel rooms on their credit cards. It's just so wrong. And you know what's even worse? When some of them tried to step forward, and these are not flaming Democrats, John. These are Trump loyalists. When they tried to step forward, stop him or report him to the White House, he fired them or otherwise discriminated against them in their jobs. So there's investigations of that. Approximately five people have lodged those investigations. It is terrible. But when I look at that list you put up on the screen, John, there's only one person who exceeds Scott Pruitt in milking the government for personal gain, and that's the president himself. And it seems to me that this is not just about Scott Pruitt. He's taken a signal from the president's emoluments, the president's spending a third of his time on his own properties, a third of the day of his presidency.
Let me read you the most recent statement from Deputy Press Secretary Hogan Gidley, because at least the official position now is maybe they're growing weary of Scott Pruitt. The official statement from Hogan Gidley, the president feels as though Scott Pruitt has done a really good job deregulating the government to allow for a thriving economy. That's important. But these things, and by these things, I think Hogan means the repeated scandals, matter to the president as well. He's looking into those. When we have an announcement, we'll make it. Ultimately, the president has the authority here. Can Congress step in here if the president doesn't act anytime soon? Could Congress theoretically, if it wanted, step in and say, you got to do something?
Well, yes. First of all, those are crocodile tears that Hogan Gidley is crying on behalf of the president. We've heard these expressions about Pruitt before. Maybe the president will fire him. It's not because the president is outraged. The president does many of the same things, John, in profiting from his public office in a way that I allege is against the Constitution. It's because the political heat is too intense. So Congress could turn up the political heat. Ultimately, it's the president's call. You know, Scott Pruitt's not going anywhere. He's as shameless as Mr. Trump himself. So if the president forces him out, fires him, then Pruitt will go. There's got to be a point at which it's too much. It's so we've never seen a cabinet member behave this way ever with this serial exploitation of public office. For personal gain. You know, it's atrocious.
Scott Pruitt doesn't see a problem here. He thinks he needs a promotion. Ambassador Norm Eisen, great to have you with us. Thanks so much. Appreciate
it. Thanks, John. Thank you.
You didn't get in enough lotion references, I don't feel
like. I got one.
That's under your usual number.
I put this out on Twitter last night. Why do I joke so much about the fact that Scott Pruitt asked his security detail reportedly to go get lotion? Because I think it's unusual for a cabinet-level secretary to send a security detail out to get lotion.
What if his hands are dry?
Is that a security risk? Is dry skin a security risk for a cabinet official?
It depends.
Cracked skin. Cracked skin is a security risk.
Chafed skin's
like DEFCON 1.
The pattern is what's so stunning this, right? It's not just the 14 ongoing investigations. It's the level of which, as Norm was saying, he's trying to profit off the office. I think aides try to procure Chick-fil-A franchises. I mean, you've got lotion and Chick-fil-A in this cavalcade of scandals.
Of goodness.
And a phone booth.
And moist.
And a phone booth, which is a pay-per-view movie. Yeah. Look, I will say this, and Norm pointed this out. One of the things that's also evident here is that there are enough people uncomfortable inside Scott Pruitt's own operation.
There are
so many whistleblowers, which is why these stories keep coming out. So there are people very uncomfortable with this who work for him.
Oh, I'm sure we've made people very uncomfortable.
Yes, I'm sure.
This morning. Indeed.